Greetings. I wanted to talk about Christianity and Islam. I wanted to present some thoughts about comparing Islam with Christianity. I want to talk about four areas we must logically consider between Christianity and Islam. We must consider 1. What does Christianity say about itself? 2. What does Islam say about itself? 3. What does Islam say about Christianity? And 4. What does Christianity say about Islam? It is important to judge whether each is consistent in its description of itself, and it is important to judge how each describes the other. Is it accurate and honest and consistent as it refers to the other? Let's take a look at these one at a time. What does Christianity say about itself? The Bible says the name of the God of Abraham is Yahweh. Christianity says it respects and worships the God of Abraham. Christianity says it is the fulfillment of the promise of God to Abraham. Christianity says it is a branch or offshoot of Judaism, which it considers itself linked to. Christianity says it respects the message of the prophets. Christianity validates this by including the message of the prophets in the Bible itself. Jesus taught God sent messengers to the Jewish people, and that he was the last such messenger. Jesus said he was the resurrection and the life. If someone would believe in him, they would live again. To prove this, Jesus raised the dead by his command. Jesus never once said, "By Allah's permission." Jesus said, "I am the Son of God." Satan said Jesus was the Son of God. Even demons said Jesus was the Son of God. Jesus said he would send the Comforter to continue teaching his message, and the Holy Spirit came. Jesus said he would be crucified, and he was. Jesus said he would rise from the dead, and he did. Jesus cursed the fig tree, and it died. Jesus spoke with authority. Christianity was started when the Romans were the most powerful force on earth. Its leader Jesus was killed in a humiliating way after only 3 years of activity. And yet, with Jesus dead, this new faith grew to the largest belief on earth with 1.8 billion followers. Jesus taught the Word of God would not pass away until it was all fulfilled. And there is no evidence today that any portion of the gospel has been lost or changed. Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but by me." So Jesus said he is the only way to eternal salvation, meaning believing he is the Son of God is the only way to eternal salvation, meaning being a Christian is the only way to eternal salvation. So in a one-sentence summary, Christianity declares that it is the gospel, meaning the good news, that the Son of God has come to bring salvation to all mankind, and it is the only way. Now let's take a look at the second situation. What does Islam say about itself? Muhammad came claiming to speak for the God of Abraham. He validated this by repeating his claim. Islam claims it respects and worships the God of Abraham. Islam claims the name of the God of Abraham is Allah, an Arabic word meaning God. Islam claims to respect the prophets. Islam claims to respect the message of the prophets. Islam claims the Torah is the word of its Allah. Islam claims the Psalms is the word of its Allah. Islam claims the Gospel is the word of its Allah. Islam claims the Quran is a handwritten book by Allah. Islam claims there is no distinction between the Torah, Psalms, Gospel, and Quran. Islam claims it is the correction for problems in the previous messages. So in one sentence, Islam claims it is the final corrected message from a deity called Allah, and that it is superior to all other religions. Submitting to Islam is the only way to peace and a chance at paradise. I will examine the consistency of the claims of Islam in another video. Here is where the comparison starts to get interesting. What does Islam say about Christianity? Islam claims Christians have a covenant with their Allah. But Islam claims Christians have forgotten half of it. Islam claims Christians are wrong to think Jesus is the Son of God. Islam claims Christians have exceeded their religion. Islam calls Christians pagans who ascribe partners to Allah. Islam teaches Christians worship Jesus and Mary as gods. Islam teaches Jesus actually followed Islam. Islam claims Jesus was not crucified. Islam claims Jesus was not killed by men. Islam claims Jesus never said he would be crucified. Islam claims there were no witnesses at the crucifixion. Islam claims Jesus never said he was the Son of God. Islam claims Allah deceived all of Jesus' followers at the cross. Islam claims Jews have corrupted the Torah and Psalms. Islam claims Jews have changed Ishmael to Isaac as the heir of the everlasting covenant. Islam claims Christians have falsified the Bible. Islam claims Christians have lost the original message Jesus brought. Islam claims a book called the Injil was written by Jesus, like the Quran was written by Muhammad. Islam claims God is not a father. Islam claims Jesus is not God's son. Islam denies the Father and the Son. Islam claims to respect Jesus as the Messiah, the Christ. So in one sentence, Islam claims that the Christians are corrupt people who have changed the scriptures and created and then followed a false message from God. Again, I will examine the consistency of the claims of Islam and the begging questions that these claims raise in another video. And finally, what does Christianity say about Islam? Christianity does not specifically and directly address Islam by name with any particular scripture in the Bible. It cannot, because Christianity and the Bible, the Word of God, was complete before any information about Islam ever existed. The Bible, and therefore Christianity, does not teach about a prophet to follow Jesus. And Jesus said he was the last messenger sent by God. But Christianity does speak of false prophets to come. The Bible, and therefore Christianity, teaches those who deny the Father and the Son are anti-Christ. The Bible teaches of a one-world religion in the last days. The Bible teaches this one-world religion will kill Christians. The Bible teaches the Antichrist will lead this one-world religion. The Bible teaches the Antichrist will follow a different calendar and celebrate different holy days. The Bible teaches this religion will be of the Antichrist. So in one sentence, there is no direct mention of Islam in the Bible, but by inference and understanding, Islam is the religion of the Antichrist to come. Christians need to study how Islam is designed to contradict, subvert, and attack Christianity. Christians need to understand that Islam hates Judaism and wishes to destroy it from the earth. This video is number one in a series which will dig deeper into these various claims by Islam. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.